back home is you'll think more of these, and that's the hope. So before we begin this, by the way, I'm very grateful that this is Mukunda and I doing together, and he's the one who's going to help us actually with the chanting part of it. So Mukunda is going to lead Kirtan. I'd like all of us to participate enthusiastically and eagerly. Sort of it sets the mood, if you will. It sets the ambience for us. So Mukunda will lead us in the Kirtan for a couple of minutes, and I'll come back and then we'll take it. Then we'll talk about a pastime or two. We'll go back into Kirtan. We'll go back pastime or two like that. So what will help me is if you can orient yourself a little diagonally so you can see the wall and Kishore Kishori at the same time. Somehow, a little, oh, there you go. Because this is part of Adbhuta Krishna is there. So, I mean, he's everywhere, but he's there. Okay, thank you.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. As you can see, some things don't work as you planned, but anyway. Thank you for joining us. One of the verses that Maharaj has been talking about as a refrain is the Nectar of Instruction, verse number 7. Syat Krishna Nama Charitadi. So Maharaj focused on the Nama, and we'll do a little on the Charita, if you will. So because it says Nama Charita Adi, Sitapi, because of this disease, na rochika, no, one doesn't have taste for Krishna's name and charita. Of course, I'm not professing that I have taste. I'm perhaps struggling. But one of the things that has helped me is over the past year or so, I've been studying Padyavali and different prayers. So it's helping me a little bit. But I'm a tough nut to crack. So Rupa Goswami says, but there is a key to it, right? Maharaj spoke on it. He says, Kintu Adarat. Adarat means, he Prabhupada translated as very carefully. Adara also means very respectfully, with great reverence. When we approach Krishna's name and charita, something happens. He says that disease begins to get cured from the root. But in that verse, in the last line, it tells us how the disease is cured. We might think that the disease suddenly vanishes one day. It's not like that. Rupa Goswami tells us, Svadvi, Svadvi means you get the taste, Kramad. Krama means to walk or to take steps. So Svadvi Kramad means step by step, gradually. Tad Bhavati, Tad Gada Moola Hantri. So this exercise is to help that step-by-step curing of our disease. So hopefully we will get some value out of it. So with that as the, I guess, frame, we thought we'll talk of certain qualities of Krishna. So we know this pastime. How we're going to do it is, we'll talk of a pastime. Hopefully we'll be wowed by Krishna. And then we will chant Hare Krishna in that spirit of, wow, Krishna, you're so amazing. Because that's our, we have to cultivate a relationship with Krishna. Unless we are wowed by Krishna, we might not be inspired to have that relationship. So we want to be wowed by him. That's the objective, if you will. So this pastime has sort of paradoxes in it. We know the story that someone complained that Krishna was eating dirt. And when Mother Yashoda said, oh, he's eating dirt, it's not good for him. Krishna, did you eat any dirt? No, I did not eat. All his friends said, yes, yes, he did. No, I did not eat. So she had to put him to the test. She said, open your mouth. When he opened his mouth and she looked inside, she was completely enamored and wowed and almost had like a little event where her head went spinning, because what she looked inside was the entire cosmos, all the planetary systems. Milky Way was a small little spot inside. The entire cosmos. And she looked at herself looking into Krishna's mouth. And she said, I need to sit down. Something is not right. I need to sit down for a moment. What am I seeing here? So the paradoxical aspect is, although Krishna is a little baby standing in front of her, being her son, little boy, he's the resting place of all living entities and all planetary systems. Yesterday's song of Bhaktivinoda Thakur was, O Krishna, you're the resting place of all the living entities. So now as we chant this section of Hare Krishna that Mukunda will lead us, let us try to appreciate how to grapple something like this. It's not easy. That Krishna looks like an ordinary young boy in front of her own son, but is the resting place of all of existence. Everything is within him. And yet, he is walking as this very sweet little boy in her backyard and in her home. Okay? So, Kishore, right there. pastime picture is here, whatever helps, let's try to appreciate Krishna's very amazing particular pastime, this one.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
This of course is a famous pastime that we spend a whole month talking about, singing about, glorifying and wondering how that is possible. So Mother Yashoda In the morning, she had to tie a waistband, a jeweled waistband around Krishna's waist. So she calls him and very easily puts a waistband, and is a very wonderful exchange, a motherly exchange. Then later that evening, when she's churning butter, I'm not going to go through the whole pastime because most of us know it already. He breaks the pot, she gets upset with him, she runs after him with a stick. Krishna starts crying in fear. Then she says, I'm going to bind you, finds a wooden grinding mortar and tries to put a rope around his waist. But something happens, or something doesn't happen. She can't. Then she wonders, maybe I need more rope. Now we might wonder, how she knows how wide Krishna's waist is, right? But she thinks, I need more rope. So she brings more rope. And that's not enough. It's always two fingers too short. So she brings more rope and more rope. She brings all the rope from 900,000 cows, puts it all together, and tries to bind Krishna. It's still two fingers too short. So to add, insult to injury, if you will, right? The neighboring gopi ladies come and start giggling. Oh, Yashoda, just this morning when you put that waistband, there was no problem. What happened now? You've brought so much rope, so long, you know, rope from 900,000 cows, and you're unable to bind Krishna. Why? What is going on? And Mother Yashoda thinks, I don't know what is going on. This is very fascinating. I've never experienced anything like this. So, you know, we've been studying Srimad Bhagavatam that Krishna is born to Devaki and Vasudev, and one might wonder, oh, I wish I had a child like that. But then are we ready for some mysteries like that every day? It's a big challenge. So it's amazing. So when we from a visual perspective, here's the total contradiction. Right in the morning, something was so easy, and by the evening, even unlimited rope was not enough to bind unlimited Krishna, who's standing there in front of her as a little boy. Isn't Krishna amazing? And more fascinating things coming up. So, yeah, go ahead.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna
So one of the lessons from this pastime is we have to appreciate that Krishna is called Swarat. Swarat means supremely independent. We begin Bhagavatam with Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Janmadhyasya Yataha Anvayat Itaratascharteshu Abhigya Swarat. So Swarat, we're talking of July 4th, Independence Day weekend. Sometimes, as a practitioner, we think that because I'm chanting Hare Krishna, I'm becoming free of the modes of nature, and by that, I can bind Krishna. I can take away his independence. Or if I do all the things I'm supposed to do, Guru Maharaj has given us tools and exercises, and if I follow them, then I can chant very nicely. That is true. It is possible, but there is a key ingredient in all of this. The other part is Krishna's mercy. So it is very much possible that when we apply these tools, one day Krishna might allow us to chant in a very happy, amazing way, we are attentive. The next day, we're looking at the same tools, we're applying the same method, we're sitting this way, we're doing that, but somehow it's such a struggle. Then we might think, oh, maybe Krishna acts only in one day periods. Day after tomorrow it might be better. It might be 6 more months before Krishna gives us, you know, one other day of wow. Because it's up to him. It is his mercy, and our whole effort is to attract Krishna's mercy through these tools. It's also the heart. We're using these. Maharaj has given us these tools to nurture our heart, to attract Krishna's mercy. Sometimes it's possible that even in one day, among the 16 rounds, right? Some are very good. When I say very good, for each one of us it means different thing, but you get the idea. Some are very good, some are very bad, some are, at least today for me, some rounds were what I call mindless babble. Suddenly I realized, what am I saying? Because I was just a little sleepy. What am I saying? I was like, oh my gosh. So sometimes it happens. In fact, one bead might be very nice. The next bead can be completely opposite, and we wonder what happened. So Krishna is the personality who's, in one sense, quite adventurous. And he's calling us to be part of that adventure. We cannot predict necessarily. The Krishna can, you know, give us some mercy, pull it back, see how we respond, give some more, pull it back. It's part of the relationship. And we are agreeing to be in a relationship with someone like this. Krishna is not a vending machine. I've heard Maharaj say it many times. Vending machine is, I put my coin, I prove my selection, I press the button, I'm supposed to get what I did. Not necessary. Because Krishna is showing us, I'm not a vending machine. And even for Mother Yashoda, in the morning you can put the waistband, no problem. By the evening, who knows? That's the challenge for us. But it's very sweet, it's very endearing. And that is part of the cultivating this relationship. We want to be in a service mood with the holy name. That's because we want a relationship. Service mood means relationship. And the relationship can be or should be on his terms. He's not obliged by us that if you are like this, I will also be exactly like. There's no rule. Although he says, ye yatha mam prapadyante. One of the devotees said very nicely that we should prepare ourselves to act on Krishna's whim. Whimsical, whim. Krishna can decide anything, anytime, any moment for us and for others. And our relationship is that I will be there in that relationship regardless of how you are. Nice, huh? Okay. Here is some other pastime. A very good friend of mine, his name was Jarasandha. He challenged Krishna. Challenged one time, got smashed, did not learn his lesson. He went a second time. You know, how many Akshauhinis of warriors did he go with? Do you remember? Either 4 or 7 Akshauhinis. Each time. 7 Akshauhinis is what the whole Pandava army was. I forget the number, some massive number like that. Almost 4 to 7 Akshauhinis. An Akshauhini is so many 25,000 cavalry, 25,000 infantry, some thousands of elephants, thousands of horses, chariot driver, all that. Went first time, got smashed by Krishna alone. Krishna didn't even have an army with him. Then he thought, maybe Krishna's having a good day. I'll try again. Second time got smashed. He didn't learn his lesson. He said, you know, sometimes people, 3 times, what's it called? 3 is the charm. He went a third time. Got smashed again. By this time, even people like us learn lessons. Jarasandha went 17 times with as many armies. Alone Krishna smashed Jarasandha. And he did not move from his position on the battlefield. Very amazing. What a strong personality Krishna is. However, I have another friend called Kalyavana. When Kalyavana came to fight with Krishna, Krishna fought with him for some time. turned around and started running away from the battlefield. So Kalyana said, "You coward, why are you running away?" And Krishna kept running. So one of the names Krishna got by this pastime is Ranachor, because he left the battlefield and ran away. You never run from a battlefield. Never. You get a bad name for doing something like that. Krishna is called Ranachor because he left. And Kalyana was like, "Why are you running away? You're not man enough to fight me." And Krishna kept running. And he kept pursuing Krishna. Of course, the pastime is, he took him to Muchkunda's cave, which when we went to Ayodhya? Dwaraka. We went to see Muchkunda's cave, little somewhere in some place. And Muchkunda was sleeping there. Krishna went all the way there. Now Krishna, how fast can Krishna run? Very fast. How fast did Krishna run? Not very fast. Because he ran only as fast as Kalyavana's hand could barely reach Krishna. See, because if Krishna darted away like, then Kalyavana would be like, "What's the point for me?" But if Krishna was right there and Kalyavana was, he always felt, you know, few more steps and I'll get Krishna. So Krishna almost like, you know, enticed him, if you will, playing with him. Right there, and kept on running and took him to Muchkunda's cave. Now Muchkunda was part of Sundari Radha's team. He didn't sleep much. So he had decided, "Tomorrow I'm going to sleep, and I'm going to sleep for 6 months," because he had recently fought a battle. And he had gotten a blessing. "Okay, sleep nicely. And whoever disturbs your sleep," he also told me, "no alarm should ring, no phone, no text. Whoever disturbs me, if I look at them, they should burn to ashes immediately." That's how desperate he was to sleep. And he got the blessing. Yes, no problem. So Krishna all the way led him to Muchkunda's cave and suddenly hid himself. So when he went into the cave, Kalyavana saw Muchkunda and thought, "Oh, this Krishna, after running so much, is tired and now sleeping," and kicked him. "Get up, you coward." And Muchkunda said, "What? More pots to wash? Sundari Radha is calling me." He turned around and looked at Kalyavana and burnt him to ashes. But Krishna ran away from the battlefield is a very fascinating thing. So on the one hand, when Jarasandha came, so Krishna treats my friends differently. You get the point, right? When one goes 17 times, smashed like anything. On the other one, the very first battle, ran away. So is Krishna predictable? We don't know. I don't know Krishna to say yes or no. But he's very fascinating nevertheless.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna.
This is one of my favorite ones. So, in Vrindavan, on a very, very cold day of Kartik, the young gopis, after performing their Katyayani Vrata, went to take bath in the Yamuna River. It was very, very cold. So they set their clothes aside and walked into the cold river, making sure there was no one around to see them. And when they were in that water, Krishna stealthily came and stole those saris away and sat on a branch of a tree and told them, for your Katyayani Vrata to become successful, all of you have to walk out of the river in a particular way. You are not allowed to walk out like this. You have to walk out with your hands like this, one by one. Everyone has to walk out that way. And they pleaded with Krishna, please, 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 don't do this. Give us our clothes back. Of course, the hidden philosophical proper meaning is they were all praying to Katyayani Devi to have Krishna as their husband. And so only he has the right to see them naked, if you will. And so he was fulfilling their ultimate desire. But he said, please walk out one by one like that. Now, it is said by our acharyas that for a woman, her chastity is the most sacred. And she will willingly sacrifice anything but the chastity. And Krishna made them give up that for him also. So they are considered the greatest in terms of their ability to serve Krishna despite any challenge. So Krishna was showing us that these are the great damsels of Vrindavan. So he took away their saris. A few years later, one of his very dear devotees, her sari was being taken away and she cried for help. Hey Krishna, hey Yadava. And the same Krishna who took away the saris gave this devotee unlimited sari to protect her chastity. So on the one hand, Krishna took away or stole the garments. On the other hand, or I shouldn't say other hand, but you get the idea, gave unlimited sari. And both were to show and to preserve the chastity of his devotees. So on the one hand, the chastity of the gopis was protected, that Krishna claimed them as his wives, in one sense. And here Draupadi's chastity was protected. So in difficult circumstances, Krishna will protect us in one way, in one circumstance, in one particular way. And in another circumstance, Krishna will demand from us something else, that challenging us to give up. One of the devotees had expressed very nicely that because the Vrajavadhus, the damsels of Vrindavan, they gave everything up for Krishna, including their chastity. And so when they met Krishna, you know what Krishna said in return, right? In the Bhagavatam, he said, I have nothing to give you. In fact, I cannot give anything back to you. Let your love be its own reward. So in the next appearance, he came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he renounced everything in honor of those gopis. That's why he's a sannyasi, constantly meditating on and glorifying the Vrajavadhus. That is Krishna's way of reciprocating back for what they did in their love for him. So, on the one hand, stole away the garments. On the other hand, unlimited garments to Draupadi.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Thank you. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
I just want to check with the audience. I hope you're not getting the message that Krishna is an unpredictable person or something like that, right? I hope not. And now whether we should even trust him because of all this chanting, who knows what is going to... It's not like that. All paradoxes, all contradictions are resolved in Krishna. The point is that Krishna is unlimitedly loving and unlimitedly merciful, except we should break the mold of seeing Krishna any one way and thinking that only if I get mercy in this particular way, then he's merciful. Otherwise, he's not. We shouldn't think like that. The idea is Krishna is a very, very multifaceted personality. And so multifaceted that the greatest of personalities like Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, they're not able to grasp the breadth of Krishna's character and nature. Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Maruta Stunvanti Divyai Stavai. They're all these great demigods are constantly reciting Krishna's glories. And that verse says, Yasyantam Navidu Sura Suragana. Yasya Antam. They cannot find an end to the breadth and depth of Krishna's character. And these are Sura and Suragana. All the host of demigods whose intellectual capacities, the language, their mental faculties are far, far exceedingly stronger than ours. Yasyantam na vidusura suragana devaya tasmai namaha. They offer prayer to Krishna. So we're only, I guess, scratching the surface in one sense. And that's because of my limitation, that how fascinating Krishna is. That's the point, not that you can, after all this, Nityananda Pran Prabhu said, we cannot trust Krishna. That's not what I'm saying. At least don't go with that message. Alright. One day, there was this discussion among a few devotees. Who's the most humble personality? Is it Lord Brahma? Is it Lord Shiva or is it Lord Vishnu? They looked around and they found a new Bhakta, Bhakta Bhrigu Muni. They told him, you're the one, as our representative, you should go and test these three personalities and come back and report us. Right? None of them volunteered, they volunteered him for it. So Bhrigu Muni accepted. So he went to Lord Brahma's palace and did not offer. I'm cutting down the pastime because there are more to show you, but you know, how many know this story? Oh, so why don't you tell me the story? So anyway, Bhrigu Muni went to Lord Brahma's palace and intentionally acted as if he was disrespecting him. Actually, it is through his mind. And in his mind, he did not properly respect him. So Lord Brahma became very angry and said, get out of here. You offended me. Then he went to Lord Shiva. And there he says, with his vacha, with his words, he insulted Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva became very upset and almost pursued him and, you know, threw him out of his Kailash. So then he went to the milk ocean. So now it is Manasa, Vacha and Gira, or by one's body. Body, mind and words, as we say. So with his body, he walked up to Lord Vishnu, who was lying down on, you know, he had just returned from work. He was sitting with his wife. Bhrigu Muni was just walked up. He didn't take an appointment, just showed up. Walked straight to Vishnu and kicked him hard on his chest. And Lord Vishnu immediately got up and said, Bhrigumuni, is your foot okay? Because it is said that my chest is as powerful as lightning. It is so strong. Vajra. Are you okay? Did you have like a fracture? Are you fine? So Bhrigumuni was completely taken aback by surprise that the other two, you know, slight offenses through the mind or through words, they got very affected. But Lord Vishnu, in fact, on the other hand, actually started rubbing Bhrigumuni's sole of his foot, saying, I hope you're okay. You know, I'm sorry. My chest, what to do? My chest is very, very strong and you kicked there. I hope you're okay. So that was, and he was very sweet with Bhrigumuni. One day, Lord Balaram, who is visiting different places, walks into Naimisharanya. And in Naimisharanya, Romaharshana Suta is sitting and speaking on the Puranas. Okay? He's Vyasadeva's disciple who's given the responsibility of propagating the Puranas. He's sitting there. Thousands of sages. This, all the sages of Naimisharanya are sitting there. Lord Balaram enters. Everyone offers obeisances. Only Romaharshana Suta did not offer obeisances. Because technically speaking, if he's sitting on the Vyasasana, he doesn't have to. But Lord Balaram did not like it. Picked up a blade of grass and struck Romaharshana. That blade of grass became so powerful as a weapon that immediately Romaharshana died on the spot. So then Bhrigumuni kicked and he was like, oh, are you okay? And here, only thing that Romaharshana didn't do was get up. Of course, we're not minimizing it. We should get up if one spiritual master comes. But he was teaching an important lesson. But you see how Krishna's, in one sense, fascinating, that what seemed like a very big offense he didn't care for, but what seemed like a seemingly small one, he took exception to it. Because disrespecting the spiritual master is a very, very grave offense. So Lord Balaram is teaching us, of course. But when you look at it just from a contrast perspective, it's interesting. Right? Agree? I mean, even if you don't agree, it's on the slide.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
Should I continue?
Yes.
A feeble yes, but I'll take anything. Okay. I'm not going to explain too much of this, although because there is not much really paradox or contradiction, but it's an interesting observation, if you will. Here's a great devotee by the name Bharat Maharaj, who had attained the bhava stage. One more step, maybe prema, Krishna prema. This is like going to the junior year of college or a junior year, you know, and one more, you're graduating. Something happened. You know, he, in the spirit of taking care of a baby deer, he lost his Krishna conscious practices. He didn't pay as much attention and intensity to his practices because he had to take care of this baby deer. Every day as he was offering oblations into the fire and chanting his mantras, he'd be wondering, where is the deer? Where is the deer? When he looked at the full moon, he looked at the full moon and said, oh, there are all these spots on the moon that looks just like this deer of mine. He became very enamored and unfortunately had to, can you come this way, Prabhu? Thank you. Unfortunately had to take the birth of a deer. That whole lifetime of being a deer and next life of Jada Bharat, an entire lifetime of being Jada Bharat. It was not like quick like this, right? And then came back to that position and attained prema. But my friend, Mr. Ajumil or Ajamil, had a whole different program. Okay? Supposedly nice Brahmin, one day went to the forest, saw somebody, two of them, you know, one, some fellow, making out with a prostitute, mind went completely off the charts, pursued that lady, got married to her, got rid of his first wife, completely neglected her, to maintain the second one and the lavish lifestyle, from Brahmana chanting mantras, he became a dacoit, started stealing from people, did all sorts of things, right? And fathered a child at 70 plus. And that when he was almost 80 years old, on his deathbed, his little boy, who he named Narayan, right? You know this story. He was about to die and he called him Narayana. Narayana, he's calling his son. And some very handsome looking people who were on the far right of the screen showed up. They were on assignment by Yamraj. And they had come to take Ajamil. But when he was saying Narayan, Narayan three times, four Vaikunthavasis also showed up. And there's a whole debate. This guy is about to die and people are arguing where he should go. I mean, it's a very difficult situation, you know. You're like, come on, decide fast. But there's a whole argument between the Vaikunthavasis and the Yamadutas as to who's going to take him. And he was always hoping that the Yamadutas will not win this argument. Every time they would say, you know, look at the list of all the things he has done. He rightfully belongs to us. It's like, no, say something, please. And then the Vishnu Dutas will say, doesn't matter. He chanted Narayana's name. He belongs to us. Yeah, yeah, like that. Then they gave scriptural references. No, no, no. According to karma theory, here he belongs to us. The Vaikuntha says, we don't care for karma theory. Once you say Narayana, everything is fine. We don't care. So he got another chance in that very lifetime. He went to Haridwar, became a very, very ardent, pakka devotee, and went back to Godhead. Somebody took three lifetimes from Bhava stage. Mr. Ajamil went away very quickly, right? So we might say, I'd rather follow Ajamil, no? It seems a little easier way. Once Gauranga Prabhu was here, and he was saying that he had heard somebody who said, after listening to Bhagavatam, he said, I like this Ajamil fellow. As they say in India, in Hindi, I'll say it in English, but Hindi first, he said, Bahut maja bhi kiya, chala bhi gaya, back to Godhead. He enjoyed life like anything, but also went back to Godhead. But that's not our model. Ajamil's lifestyle is not our model. Ajamil's lifestyle is our model after he went to Haridwar, not when he was in Kanpur, not for us to follow. He's in a place called Kanauj, which is not far from Kanpur. So, why? Why Bharat had to take three births? Ajamil got something. So it's not like Bharat Maharaj was given something less. Actually, Bharat Maharaj was given something greater in one sense. The intensity, the longing to be with Krishna became so intense as Jada Bharat. So whether it looks contradictory here or not, Krishna is only interested in one thing: to increase our longing for Him, to increase our desperation for Him. He really wants us to want Him.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
I have a question to ask. How many of us are secretly nourishing this idea that one morning we'll wake up and all our anarthas will have gone and we'd be just pure devotees? Secretly, anyone? Now it's not a secret anymore, but okay. I'm sorry to break your bubble or our bubble. I also feel like that. That's not what we signed up for. That is called Kripa Siddhi. That line is the honorary degree line. We have signed up for what is called Sadhana Siddhi, which means small increments every day. Not that it cannot happen. Anything can happen, of course, but that's not our path what we signed up for. Okay, we signed up for, remember, Svadvi Kramat Tad Bhavati. Svadvi Kramat, the taste for Krishna, the taste of that relationship with Krishna develops incrementally, step by step. Of course, Krishna is free to give us the honorary degree and say, you know, you're done up to 10th grade, we'll just give you the engineering degree because we don't want to see you in college anymore. It's not like that. He can, but we signed up for going through the school. A school of developing into a pure devotee. So, let's not feel rushed or, you know, stand, wake up one day and it'll not be something that my wife will also not recognize me. She will always recognize you. All right. One day, she talk of wife and husband, and the next topic is of Krishna playing the role of a very doting husband. Anywhere in Chicago. It's not available anywhere on planet Earth. It's available only in Indra's backyard, the Nandanandana garden. But he also, she is on the left, the clouds, you know the whole pastime, Maitri. Whole battle, and Krishna became very happy. Whole kingdom was taken away by Bali Maharaj. And Indra went crying. Indra's mother went crying. Scared of Bali. And Bali Maharaj did not come with all he brought was the armies. And he marched into Indra's Amravati city. And when he saw Bali Maharaj and the whole army coming, Indra's like, whoa. better not fight them. And he was advised, if you can escape from the back door, that will be best for you. So he went and was hiding in Aditi's ashram. And Bali Maharaj sat on the throne and became the king of the heavenly realms. So when Aditi went crying, please do something, Lord Vishnu said, I will come as Vamana. Came as Vamana, he did not go to Bali and tell him, I'll fight with you. He begged him, please give it to me. So when it came to Indra, he fought with him and took away a Parijata tree, a whole kingdom, he only begged. And that too, according to Jayadev Goswami, it was chala. Chala means deception. He asked for one thing and took something else away. Jayadev Goswami says, Chalayasi Vikramane Balim Adbhuta Vamana. Chalayasi Vikramane. He deceived Bali. He told him, I want 3 paces of land. And Vamana means dwarf. Dwarf is a person who has a very long torso and short legs. So one who has short legs cannot cover enough land. Someone who is very tall can cover lot of land and, you know, relatively lot more land in 3 paces. So when he said, I only want 3 paces of land, Bali said, are you joking? Are you kidding? I can give you an entire planet to rule upon. And you'll be the king to such a degree that for the rest of your life, for the rest of your descendants' life, you don't have to beg. Forever. I have so much wealth, I'm willing to give you. And Vamana said, a Brahmana should not be greedy. He should only take that which he can manage. So give me 3 paces of land. So Bali laughed. you're being very immature. Anyway, take 3 paces of land. As soon as he said that, Vamana became so big. With one step, he covered all of the lower regions. Second step, all of the upper worlds. And said, hey, one more step. What am I to do? You didn't fulfill your promise. Bali Maharaj said, please put it on my head, because once I give myself, that means everything is gone to you. So Krishna has, I should say, tactics. If necessary, he will fight and take. He will deceptively beg and take. But if he wants to take, Rakhe Krishna Mare Ke, Mare Krishna Rakhe Ke. So if he says, please give, and we say, something, he has ways. He knows by which to take. But the ways by which he takes, what's coming up is the way which he gives also. Krishna is not only taking. We one think, you know, all I'm doing for him is taking and taking. And he's also giving liberally, non-stop, liberally giving. But when he wants to take, he has his ways. Isn't it? Prabhupada said, if you hold behind, and Krishna is asking something, you hold behind and you give something, Krishna is not interested in what you are giving, he is interested in what you are holding back.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
I have many other pastimes to show you, or I guess share with you, but I'm curious to hear from you. Was this helpful? Anything particularly connected well for you? It did not touch you at all? It's possible. Anything? Anyone wants to share? Yes, Madhu.
Yeah, thank you, Prabhu. It really helps. Because the first, the PowerPoint you showed, the slide, when Krishna, when Yashoda saw inside his mouth, like the whole thing is resting on him. And Mukunda, when he sang the Hare Krishna mantra, really touches the heart. Really at that time it feels like, yes, we have to, I mean, surrender fully onto Krishna. So.
And if Mukunda would not do it, we'd not get there. Thank you.
Thank you.
It helps, no, when it's not just the visual, but the sweetness with which he sings and he engages us. So, thank you.
Thank you very much, Prabhu.
Thank you. Anyone else? Marty?
I liked the way you were telling, the comparing both, how he reacted differently. That made me think that he has his own personality. Like he reacts however he wants to. And I like the word Adbhuta Krishna. So I was enjoying the comparison. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Naveen.
Thank you very much, Prabhu. I like the, I mean, the contradiction. I'm waiting for the climax. What is the message for us?
Okay. That's part of the climax. You have to figure it out.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, it's a very nice way, because often the mind thinks why Krishna acted in one situation like this, another. So the way you very nicely put what my mind is thinking and how you address that, Krishna can act in any way, but my job is to completely surrender.
And he is giving love and affection and mercy, just as giving in a way that we're thinking, why like this, why not like that?
So the one thing the logic doesn't answer everything. Yeah. So that's what my lesson.
Pratik, and then Sumangala.
Thank you, Prabhu. This was a nice compare and contrast. Specifically, since we are meditating on the holy name, and holy name is not different than Krishna. So when you mentioned about how we can, you know, we may be able to chant properly or we may not be able to chant. One mantra we may chant perfectly, the other mantra, next mantra, you don't know where your mind is. So when you compare when you compare that example to this, it is possible, anything is possible in Krishna, in Krishna's hands, and everything is in Krishna's hands and anything is possible. So we can try to put our endeavor, but then we cannot expect that it's going to happen that way, specifically with the chanting of the holy name. So
correct. Prabhupada said that ours is the monkey method, not the cat method. There are some Vaishnava lines that believe that it's the cat method. Cat model is, you know, the kittens are there and the mother cat holds them by the neck and takes them from one place to another place, and the kittens are totally helpless. Our philosophy is the monkey model, that the baby monkey grabs on to the mother and then the mother goes from one branch of a tree to another branch of another tree. So both endeavor and mercy, both are required. Endeavor is in our part, mercy is in Krishna's. Unfortunately, as young devotees, we use our endeavor to manipulate Krishna's mercy. And that is something we have to learn too, that endeavor is my department, mercy is Krishna's department. So Mangala, you had something?
Thank you so much, Prabhuji, wonderful class. I was thinking initial slides, where is my practical message from you, because whenever I, you know, work with you, I get practical message. But as Prabhuji said, I got a climax scene, you know. It's really practical. When we get the miseries, the mind usually goes towards, why Krishna, why are you doing this to me? But rather looking from the other side, what Krishna is giving, you know. Every time when he's sending something, there is a, in all of these, he's trying to achieve, like, you know, something from that devotee, you know. So this helps, like, you know, don't expect everything nice, even miseries, there is something, you know, hidden.
During this weekend, I learned something for myself, was instead of, why Krishna, are you doing this to me? Lesson from is, why Krishna, why am I doing this to you? That's what I learned from you.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Any final comment? Sridharanand? In the back.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji and Mukund Prabhu. So, all those pastimes I enjoyed, especially that Kalyavan and Jarasandh, and next to the Ajamila stories. And I'm so happy to know today that you have so many friends in your Krishna's pastimes.
I didn't speak about my best friend Duryodhan yet, but anyway. I'll say it privately. Sometimes I wonder why Maharaj named my son Prahlad. And I always thought it was an indirect way of calling me Hiranyakashipu. Okay, I'm going to skip, although I'd love to speak on Ramayana, then I won't be able to finish, so I'm going to skip this one. This one's last one, we'll end and give a few minutes for transition into Sunday feast. This wonderful pastime of Govardhan Leela, Krishna lifted the Govardhan hill for 7 days, we know that beautiful pastime. After all of that was done, Krishna put Govardhan hill back, and Govardhan hill was like hungry, right? So all the villages around were told, cook something and bring to offer to Govardhan. So they were not cooking, you know, Sunday feast capacity or Rath Yatra capacity. Every household in all of the villages brought everything that they had, big, big cartloads of food, and offered to Govardhan. He ate it all up and he said, Aneor, I want some more. Then the next set of villagers cooked everything that they had, brought in big, big cartloads, offered him. He ate that and he said, I want some more. He went on and on and on and ate villages and villages worth of food. Of course, everything was mystically appeared back for them as Mahaprasad, but that was his appetite. Some years later, Mahabharata, okay. You know which one? Yeah. So some years later, Draupadi and the Pandavas are in the forest, and Shriman Durvasa Muni comes for lunch with, sometimes said 20,000, sometimes said 60,000, we'll say 60,000 disciples, and they were all hungry. And they said to Draupadi, we're hungry. And Yudhishthira Maharaj said, please take a bath in the river, she will cook lunch. I mean, imagine someone shows up in the house and 60,000 people you have to cook for. But he was, you know, confident, oh, we have this Akshaya Patra, magic pot. And it will produce as much food as necessary, except condition was, once Draupadi eats from it, he will stop producing food for the day. And Durvasa Muni and his disciples came after Draupadi had eaten. It was part of a major plot by Duryodhana. So when all these disciples, they were all taking bath in the river, Draupadi started having a panic attack. She was panicking. And she had heard stories about Durvasa Muni. You know, he can curse very quickly. So when she was crying, suddenly there was a knock on the door. And she opened the door, it was Krishna. And he said, I'm hungry. He said, I already have enough hungry people. To not feed you would be another mistake. What to do? So bring that Akshaya Patra. And he took one small grain from it and ate it. And he was completely satisfied. And not only was he satisfied, Durvasa Muni and all his 60,000 disciples in the river were burping. We're full. We don't feel like eating. No lunch. We're done. And they all went away. So on one hand, mountains of food is not satisfying. But on the other hand, one grain from Draupadi's pot is very satisfying. This is wonderful Krishna. So Mukunda will lead us into last kirtan. We're asked, get down. Thank you. Thank you very much. And we'll transition into Sunday feast. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.